Have you ever heard a sound like this? If that sound was familiar to you, congratulations, you are probably taking very good care of your teeth because this is a device for cleaning your teeth called a WaterPik. It's a hydro flosser, which, as you probably know, squirts water through this wand into your teeth to try and get the stuff that gets in your teeth out from between your teeth, and it also massages your gums and so on and so forth. You can find out a lot more about WaterPik if you're interested in it by visiting the WaterPik company and discovering everything they want to tell you about it. This machine was given to me by somebody because it was broken. It had frozen up, and it wasn't given to me for repair. It was given to me for parts, in case I could use some of the parts from the machine for my tape recorder work. When I got into the machine, I found out why it had frozen up. It was filled with a bunch of gunk, probably from the water, or who knows what was put into the machine. And it is a vintage machine. The person who gave it to me, I had gotten it in 1992, and the motor froze up, and so just wound up in the basement, and we were having a discussion, and I inherited the machine. Obviously, I'm not going to use this machine myself, because it's a personal hygiene device, and I am not the person who was originally using it. So this is just simply here for exploration, and I thought it might be fun to take a look at how one of these devices actually works. Before I begin the video, I want to give you a warning. WaterPik is an AC-powered device that works with water to clean your teeth, as you obviously know. Electricity and water obviously do not mix. If you have a WaterPik and anything goes wrong with it, don't attempt to repair it yourself. Send it back to the WaterPik people, and they will fix it and return it to you. Play safe. Clydesight Productions is not responsible for anything that you do to your WaterPik or yourself as a result of watching this video. This video is a documentary of how this particular machine works. It is not intended to teach you how to repair a WaterPik. Do not attempt to repair a WaterPik yourself. Anybody who has a WaterPik will recognize this design. There is this rather stiff tubing here. It's stiff for a reason. And then there is this wand which comes out. As you can see, there is a special tip that you get that plugs into the wand here. And that is basically how the water gets out of the machine and into your mouth. Now, we also have this piece here, which is the water reservoir. You can see it has a little rubber bumpy here. This is a rubber valve, and that is what makes the water come out of the inside of the reservoir and into the machine here. The rubber piece here is actually, it's a little tiny valve, and it moves up and down very slightly. And we'll take a look at that in a minute. And the way it's able to do that is because of the underside of it, which is pushed by a piece of the machine back here. And that pushes it up. When it's not pushed up, water can't get out. It acts as a plug. The reservoir is just sitting freely right now on top of the device. And I'm going to push it down to show you how the plunger works. Watch the little black plunger. Did you see it go up? Now I've lifted it off and it's back down. It's a very small amount of motion. Watch again. See it go up? It works just like the plug in your bathtub drain, if you have one that goes up and down. This is the outer case, and something that you will notice is, of course, that they put a switch here that you press with your finger. And that is just simply a up and down piece of plastic. The plastic switch works with this plunging mechanism here to actually put power to the motor. And this works very similarly to the clicker on a ballpoint pen. The secret is all in this part of the mechanism right here. It's a little hard to understand because this is all clear, but basically you have the plunger here, and you have what's basically a locking arm here. And that locking arm is controlled by this spring located here. Now, there are grooves cut in this brown piece of plastic that will guide a pin on this arm so that it does the locking and unlocking action. Now watch when I push it down. Notice that this arm is being pushed over by the shape of the brown plastic. And you heard the click then. It got past the groove and it swung into the center position because of this spring. Now when I release it, it locks up into what is an inverted V. So it's in the bottom of the V and it can't go any further up. Now when I push it down again, because of the shape of the V, it moves over again under the influence of the spring and escapes the V. Now it's in the secondary groove and it comes up and is forced by the plastic groove into this position where it can go down and lock again. So let's watch that slowly. Ready to lock. Locked. Ready to release. Release. It's an ingenious system. Now, this is powering the motor. Let's see what happens when the motor is working. The motor is a simple single pole squirrel cage type motor. You'll find these in can openers and fans and other devices. And it turns a gear here, which is attached to a transfer rod, and that transfer rod actually goes to a piston located in the actual pump. And this is the pump. It looks very complicated, but the principle is very, very simple. Water from the reservoir comes down through this hole here and floods the piston chamber. Now, as the motor gear turns, it pulls the piston to the back part of the chamber. As it continues to turn, it pushes the piston forward. When the piston comes forward, it forces water out through this tube here, which is part of the wand, which then pushes the water into your teeth. So, it's a very simple piston action. I think if this was an internal combustion engine, you'd call it a single stroke. And this is a centuries-old design of a simple pump. So it's brilliant the way they use this to pulse water into your mouth to clean your teeth, because the pulsing action is what stimulates your gums and so on. I've removed the two motor screws, and that releases the stator part of the motor completely from the rotor. And here is the rotor here. The rotor sits on an axle, which is part of the actual device itself. This is a very different construction from what you would normally see, where the motor has its own axle. So it simply is on this axle and is able to spin. Now, the other end of the motor here, as you can see, has a white gear on it. And that gear engages this gear here. So when I slide it down, you can see that's the very simple way that this device works. Very, very clever. The gear itself here will come off the travel arm, and we can now see that the piston has a ring on the top of it, which engages this boss here in the gear. If you've ever worked on a car engine or any kind of internal combustion engine or ever seen the design for one, this is exactly the same concept. And so you can see that as the gear turns, because this is eccentric, it will move this back and forth, and that works the piston. We see here is the pump head, here is the piston housing, and here is the piston. And the piston will slide right out. The inside of the piston chamber is made of a plastic, a very smooth plastic, but it's very tight with the pistons. As this piston goes in and out, it pulls water through the intake valve, this tube, and fills the chamber, and then when it goes into the second part of the stroke, it pushes it out through this tube. Why doesn't it push water up back into the reservoir? The key is in the pump head itself, so we'll take a look at that now. I'm going to twist it and then carefully pull it apart and lift it off. And we see there's a valve located right here. And that valve comes out, and there's an O-ring, which I'll tap out so that I don't lose it. So here we have all the parts. We have the pump head, the piston chamber, the O-ring for sealing, and the valve. And the way this valve works is it has a rubber tip on it, and it simply moves up and down like that inside the pump head. So when the water is being pushed by the piston, it pushes the valve up, sealing this tube so that the water can't squirt back up into the reservoir. And when the piston pulls, this comes down, allowing water to leak into the piston chamber here, filling it up so that in the next stroke, the piston can push the water through this tube. And that's how they get that pulsing action using this device. The piston head itself does the work because of, you can see there is a rim here of very special flexible plastic. And that rim presses against the piston, the walls of the piston chamber, keeping it sealed. And that's one of the secrets to why this piston works as well as it does. It doesn't use a round O-ring or anything like that. It's just this little piece of plastic that they bonded to the piston itself. And it's a very flexible little piece of plastic that does the work. I have the mechanism all put back together. We see the gear here, the motor is here, here's the pump, and here is the plunging switch for the device. Now, when the switch is down all the way, the machine is off. When it's released and goes up, it's on. So you can see how this very rapidly moves this pump back and forth. Thank you for watching the video on this WaterPik machine that I cleaned up and got actually working again. I'm not going to be using it for my personal dental hygiene. I have a WaterPik of my own that works perfectly well. This video was created to show you how this vintage WaterPik actually worked. Do not attempt to repair a WaterPik yourself. Clydesight Productions is not responsible for anything you do to your WaterPik or yourself as a result of watching this video. But please do stay tuned to Clydesight Productions for other interesting videos. Mostly we concentrate on tape recorders, but every now and then we will go and explore something else that shows clever and ingenious engineering as the WaterPik device does.